Hi, good afternoon everyone. So post lunch is a little difficult session for everyone, and I hope to keep you awake. See, I work for Reliance. Reliance is a telecom operator based out of India, and we are in both mobile as well as fixed space. Although our primary focus is on the mobile side, we have close to 100 million mobile subscribers. We have about 8 million 3G subscribers, which is our mobile broadband service, the one I handle. And we have about close to 300,000 M2M connected devices as a part of our network. So this is where I come from. Ours is a very low ARPU country. The typical ARPU is in the range of $2.5 to $3 US. And the M2M ARPU is maybe around $1, you know. So that is the kind of ARPUs we work on. Well, whichever analyst report you refer to, the projected explosion in M2M is huge. I mean, there are projections right up to saying that 2020 will have 50 billion connected devices, while here is a little more conservative estimate by Juniper, which says 2014 we'll have 412 million devices which are connected. Now, what are the challenges, the business challenges which will come up as a result of this? See, I am actually from the business background. I'm not a network person per se. So a lot of what I talk today is come from the business perspective. Although my whole session is about the impact on networks, but it is maybe a business person's view of the network. So one is the availability of the number series, which is going to be a huge challenge, followed by the IP pool. We are running out of IP addresses. And third is the capacity to manage both incremental signaling traffic as well as the user traffic, because there are some applications which are quite bandwidth hungry too, although most aren't. Now, I look at what is it that we have on the menu card of M2M? So I have put together the whole suite of applications into six broad categories. One is around the security and alarms, which seems to be a big draw at broadband forum. I see quite a few exhibitors talking about it. The other is around tracking and tracing. So be it vehicles, be it people, be it assets. Third is about metering, so most popular being energy meters, followed by gas, water, and similar applications. Then payment is a very big thing. So let's say that's what I was talking to him, that we already have close to 200,000 payment M2M devices in India. So we have what we call lottery terminals, which are connected. We have the credit card swipe machines which are connected, and we also have a lot of ATM connectivity. So these are the M2M applications in the payment space. So far what we have deployed at Reliance is tracking and tracing. We have close to 100,000 vehicles which are using this device that we have, the VTS as we call it, and about 200,000 devices on the payment side. That's what is live in our network. We are very aggressively looking at a good solution in the security space. And that's the next focus we have on the M2M. And as far as metering is concerned, we actually have another sister concern, which is Reliance Energy, which is India's largest energy distribution company. So the metering has been actually deployed by that company. We have just given them connectivity. So they have another close to 200,000 AMRs already deployed. So if I add that, it becomes 500,000 M2M devices we have on our network. And our sister concern, which is Reliance Energy, already has it. They have 225 million subscribers. So far, we have deployed AMR only at the high-end enterprise customers. But slowly, it is going to trickle down to a much larger population. Healthcare and remote maintenance, I haven't seen anything happening, but these are maybe future potentials for deployment of M2M. Now coming to analyzing these applications, why talk about these applications? The reason is that each application is different from the network perspective. And the kind of challenge each application will have on the network is going to be very different. So there is no single rule for network impact of M2M applications. So the three, four key variables are what is the kind of bandwidth required, which is your data volume. So as you can see, except for surveillance, you don't actually need high bandwidth for most other applications. Even in surveillance, say, what we have deployed in ATM, since bandwidth was a challenge, what we have done is the security application works pretty good even at a video frame rate of 1 frame per second. And the moment we throttle the video to 1 frame per second, that gives us a very good, that gives the bandwidth requirement comes down drastically. And so you don't really need very high bandwidth even for a surveillance application. And while talking to a few security agencies, they say that they don't really need a 20 frame per second or a 30 frame per second fee. So another is about quality of service. Now let's look at AMR. Now AMR needs to actually transmit data maybe 3 times a day or something, at best 3 times a day. So it's not so critical if it gets delayed a bit. Or let's look at maybe something like a POS terminal. Now that is where a QoS is very critical. A credit card swipe can't fail. So you have two diverse applications as far as the quality of service is concerned. Your security is also a very high QoS demanding application. And then the amount of signaling. The key challenge, as we know, in M2M is that the ratio of total traffic to signaling traffic is highly loaded in favor of signaling, because there are large number of transactions which happen of small volume. So the applications like energy meters, your surveillance cameras, they have a very high, they have very low signaling load, while you have applications like fleet management where the signaling load is very high. So finally, when you are designing networks, you have to decide which applications are we going to focus on, and your challenges will then boil down to those application specific challenges rather than a generic M2M challenge. Well, just an overview of the M2M ecosystem. You have some asset, which could be a vehicle, which could be an energy meter, or an ATM, or a camera, which needs to be tracked. Then you have the communication device or the module, the M2M module, which will go inside the asset. And you have the operator network, and you have a services platform, and you have the applications. So as an operator, we are looking at playing an active role in 3 out of these 5 components. As we are looking at the communication device, we are looking, obviously the network is our core business, and the M2M services platform, which is where we will be provisioning the customer and the managing the quality of service for the customer, billing. So all those elements will be be managed through the M2M services platform. So the M2M value chain,
think this is more relevant from the panel discussion. I'll maybe skip this, but broadly we are saying that there is the device manufacturer, there is the enterprise, there is system integrator, there is operator, there is the final user, there is somebody who installs and puts together that device inside the, you know, the vehicle or wherever, or the meter. So I think we'll look at this in the panel discussion. Okay, now coming to the core of today's discussion, what are the key impacts on network by deploying M2M devices on your network, and especially the explosion that is going to happen over the next few years. So one thing we see on the network is there are significant peaks every 30-60 minutes. That is because the applications have a scheduler which runs periodically, and typically they would have programmed it every hour, so maybe 4 o'clock, 5 o'clock, 6 o'clock is how they have scheduled the data transfer. So suddenly at 4 o'clock you will see a huge peak, and at 4:02 it's died down. So that is the kind of peaks you see at every half an hour to 1 hour. Second is your POS machines typically peak between 6 to 8. I'm talking because we have a large number of POS machines on our network, and this happens to be the voice peak hours too in India, between 6 to 8. People talk after office, people don't talk during office, so in India at least. The third is that if and when there is a network outage or a power outage, and power outages are very common in India, where you know, especially in rural India, there is a large amount of power outages which happen. And so whenever that happens, at the moment the network comes back, suddenly you will have maybe 500,000 devices which are trying to connect to the network. So that leads to a huge number of bandwidth requests, and managing that on the random access channel becomes a huge challenge. You know, the AAA can't manage that load, the random access can't manage that load whenever these kind of network or power outages happen. And another is your nature of M2M traffic, which is your signaling challenge, where you have large volume of small messages, and the smallest spectrum allocation unit is a PRB, a physical resource bandwidth. So the minimum bandwidth which is allocated can carry much more than what is actually carried on the M2M message. So your utilization of spectrum is quite inefficient, and that leads to a need for much more spectrum than what any operator would have. And this conflicts with the fact that your ARPUs are very low. So it is not justified to deploy more spectrum for M2M. Now, how do we overcome these four challenges? So one thing we do is we work very closely with the application provider or the whoever is develop the application, and then we work with him that the scheduling of the data transfer within the application, supposing he has 100,000 devices, then we tell him that don't program all of them to transmit at 4 p.m. Even if you want an hourly transfer, maybe keep a 2 second gap and say 100 devices transmit at 4 p.m., another 100 transmit at 4 p.m. and 2 seconds, because the transaction typically takes not more than 2 seconds. So it's at a maybe 2 second, 3 second interval, he will kind of space out his entire, you know, batch of M2M devices. So that is one way that we kind of spread the traffic of M2M. You know, but otherwise, any network planning has to be planned for the peak, and it becomes very unviable to then service an M2M customer. Second is that we work with enterprise customers to maybe have a kind of a time-based tariff rather than a byte-based tariff, because byte-based tariffs are very good when it comes to surfing or normal internet usage, smartphone usage. But on M2M, they are not efficient because you So that comes to just 1 cent is 30 cents a month. So that's all you get out of that customer. But the amount of spectrum it takes is much more. So you'll have to figure out the right tariffing for the M2M customer. So if you do a time-based tariff, that means you are charging him for the amount of time that he has used the spectrum. Then another, coming to power outages, maybe you have to limit the number of repeat attempts to access the network. So again, in the application level, the time gap between two requests could be programmed at say 1 second or something like that. And lastly, your number, the mobile number series, I think we have to look at moving to our 11-digit mobile numbering plan to have a larger pool, because finally all billing happen on the basis of mobile numbers in the billing system. So, or you have to move away from a mobile number based billing and have a static IP based billing. So there has to be some innovation thought around this challenge of not having enough mobile numbers. And another is your IPv6. See, because in India we have already got 700 million mobile voice customers. So the amount of mobile numbers available are quite limited. Sorry. Now another challenge, now this is specific to the signaling problem, that the random access channel, it gets choked when there are large number of bandwidth requests which are simultaneous. And there are four ways of kind of handling this problem. So one way I already spoke about, whether that you keep a minimum time gap between retries. So that is working with the application provider. Second is you have what is called access-based barring. Now, access-based barring works the same as a backup scheme, just that it is managed at the network layer. So the network will not allow a repeat access beyond a certain time frame or within a certain time frame. And another solution is around maybe dividing your RACH resources between M2M and non-M2M traffic. So you clearly say that if I have X volume of RACH, yeah, then I divide it between the two. And lastly, have a dynamic allocation between M2M and non-M2M traffic. Okay, this is the last slide. This is about how, this is a live example of KDDH, how they have implemented vehicle tracking, whereby the moment the vehicle is stationary, the application will signal to the platform, and platform will signal to the network, and network will change the parameters like paging area and location registration. And that way your network resources are much better utilized. Otherwise, even when the vehicle is stationary, you are using the same resources as your moving vehicle. So you kind of shrink your resources the moment the vehicle becomes stationary. So this is one innovation which has been done in KDDH already on vehicle tracking systems. That's it. So how much time do we have for questions?
Very little, actually. But I'll take one or two short ones, and then anything can be directed back to Manu in the interactive discussion.
One quick question. This is a great, thank you for that, from the transport connectivity layer, right. Tim. But I'm just curious from a business side. Immature, highly fragmented market in NTM. Plus, you have some unique challenges around ARPU. So, are you finding that you find opportunities with particular use cases, and then that you're bringing in the application vendor to work with the end customer, or is the application provider or system integrator coming to you with the customer and saying, "Hey, we need to solve this"?
So we have both scenarios. I think we have there are scenarios where we own the customer and we source the application, and the application provider gets the customer and we kind of work with him to give the solution to the customer. I think this is a much better address in the panel, because the panel is about the whole ecosystem. Deployment of IPv6 on M2M only. That's what our plan for IPv6.
And it's just the difference between IPv6.
Yeah.
Yes.
One more quick question.
Okay. Thanks. Thanks. Thanks.